Rox, random question. How did you manage your 9-to-5 with trading? I was pretty fortunate, to be honest with you, because I was in sales. So I had access to my own space, my own computer, my own internet, and I was able to trade from work. But anybody that's trading, to be honest with you, my recommendation would be to focus on the 4H time frame only, work with the two candle theory. Set your alerts 2 minutes before the 4H candle closes, or let's say 30 minutes after the candle closes, 15 minutes after candle closes. Take a bathroom break, take out your phone, check if it's strong, check the currency strength, set a sell stop or buy stop, place your stop loss in a reasonable space. You have to accept you don't have the luxury of getting tighter entries. So let's say the candle closes bearish and you see that, you place your stop loss here. You enter with a sell stop once it goes red, and you just be grateful for your targets. You hold it to see if it goes down, or you just be grateful for whatever you get after that 4H candle closes. That is how you have to approach trading. What you don't want to do is start hating your job because it interferes with your trading, because that's not true. Trading is not as important as your job because your 9-to-5 is what carries you. Do you understand? And I know you don't want to believe that because you don't want that to be the case. You want trading to carry you. But once you accept that reality, you'll be able to focus more at work. You'll be able to get a lot more out of your trading. And you will start to realize what it really means to be a patient, consistent trader. I mean, when I was working trading, I was the most disciplined ever, to be honest with you. I really was the most disciplined. Now I have so much freedom. I had to work on winding that down because I was like, I've got so much more time now. I could trade any time frame I want, any pair I want, any time I want. And you don't want that kind of freedom as a trader. You want boundaries. And I think when you're working, it is the best opportunity to start practicing and learning those skills, which is the most important thing that is going to get you to where you need to get to as a full-time trader. And I'm going to be honest with you, bro. You do not need any other approach to the markets than what I'm telling you. If the candle closes bullish and you want to take a buy, enter the trade, place your stop loss below the previous candle. It makes sense. And then you either hold for 1-to-1 or you just hold it until the evening, the next day, to wherever you're satisfied, and just keep working on this. At this moment in time, if you're working a 9-to-5, your focus shouldn't be making money. Your focus should be acquiring the skills necessary for you to make money when you become or decide to go full-time trading. In that time, I would be focusing on working more hours at work, getting a weekend job to save up enough money to give myself a cushion for 3 to 6 months so that when I know I'm confident enough because I've practiced enough whilst working to be consistent, profitable, disciplined, patient, and everything else that you need to then say, here you go, time to hand it in. But you're not ever going to be able to leave your job unless you're not going to be able to leave your job to become a full-time trader unless you have full confidence and belief in what you're doing. And that starts at work with the process that you implement right off the bat. So it's an advantage, I believe personally, more so than a disadvantage. So find a way. Figure it out. A lot of the stories you hear as well of actually really successful traders are traders who were at college or university and they used to take trades between classes. You know what sets them apart from the majority of traders? It's not because they had a strategy that was foolproof or it was the Holy Grail. It was simply because they learned the art of execution and holding and accepting the outcome. And I promise you guys, hand on my heart, that is the reason why a lot of them succeed. And especially this day and age as well, a lot of the younger traders, especially, go and look for yourself on YouTube, check out the FTMO videos. How often do you find 1 minute, 5 minute, 15 minute traders passing their challenges with partial profits, this and that? You'll find a lot of the traders that are passing challenges are traders that know the art and the skill of executing and holding. And that is the advantage you have at work. And there's so much to gain from that as well, because whilst you're at work, you're going to want to be checking your phone. You're going to want to see if your trade's winning. If you learn to just disconnect, even though it's going to be so difficult for the first week, 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 3 months, if you can practice disconnecting to the outcome, to the immediate results or outcome of that trade, you will become one of the greatest traders ever once you decide to go full-time trading. Because you will not have to deal with 99% of the problems that traders face now, which is the emotional aspect, because you would have removed it. So it's an advantage, bro. Think about that. The one thing I will say as well, if you have to ask, do you think I should leave my job with 6 months savings to go full-time trading? You already have your answer. Because the only reason you're asking is because you're doubting. And the reason you're doubting is because you haven't yet found consistency with your trading. So if you have to ask, it means you're not ready. If you have to question whether you should take a challenge, it means you're not ready. Do you understand? So personally, you guys have to understand, it's not personal to me actually, but personal to you, you have to understand that if you want to make progress, you have to position yourself to a certain point or stage that you know that you're capable of achieving results. And then you have to create a well-defined plan of how you think you're going to get there. Because even if you did have 6 months savings and you are not yet consistent or profitable as a trader, or you can't even get 10% a month, your first 2 months might seem like you have 4 months left, but realistically you don't, because on your third month, you've got to pass the challenge in the hope that you do pass it that month. And let's say you do, that's month three. You then go into month four to have to pass your verification. If you pass it in month four, all well and good, you then need to trade another month to even make money as a trader. So that's month five, leaving you in a position where you get paid on month six in the hope that you start making money beyond that point with little to your name, because you've used most of your savings for your down pay, for your rent and whatever else. You don't want to put yourself under that stress. You just don't. And listen to me, if you want to really become a full-time trader, there's so much hype around being full-time trading. You have to realize this is a serious business, man. This is no way, in any way, shape or form, easier than your 9-to-5. No way. I don't care whether you're working in oil rigs, whether you're working underground, whether you're having to get yourself dirty in sewage pipes. I don't care what anybody says. Trading is one of the hardest things you will face or have to do, encounter if you do embark on this journey in your life. The mental and emotional trauma, the difficulties with your anxiety and everything else that surrounds trading is so difficult. The reason why it doesn't seem that way is because it's the simple ideology that you just execute a buy or sell, you manage your risk, and you wait for take profit. The entry level to trading is almost zero, that because you can get in for free, you think that you should get what you supposedly deserve out of the markets. But it's not true, guys. It's just not true. Of course, after a couple years of consistency and profitability, you start to become more comfortable within your own skin and trading, et cetera, et cetera. But just because you can pass a damn challenge or verification and get funded, it does not mean you will be a successful trader. It does not mean that at all. Because the variations with trading, the outcomes in terms of your results and that are so wild. They swing so many different ways that it's just tough, man. And when you start making money as a trader, you know, my outgoings at the moment are around 17 and a half grand a month. My outgoings, okay, that is my outgoings at this moment in time. Now, if I left my job and I went into trading, and let's say I made 50 grand in the first month, with that 50 grand, I didn't know how to manage my expenses. how to deal with my taxes. I just got excited by the fact that I've made 50 grand. I then go and buy 75 inch TV, sign up to Sky, get a new lease on a car, et cetera, et cetera. Now my expenses have gone from 1500 to, let's say, 3.5, 4 grand because I made 50 grand the last month. You go and spunk the money on whatever else you're going to do. You come back the next month, you make 30 grand. Then the next month, you make 15 grand because the markets are shit. Then the next month, you make 10 grand. Now, you not only have the pressure of the fact that you're not making the 50 grand a month that you expect to be making for the previous 3 months, you now also have the pressure knowing that your bills have gone up to 3.5, 5 grand a month. And how are you going to deal with that situation? Do you understand? It is a very serious business. And if you want to be successful in this business, there is so much you have to change and be prepared for. I'm going to be brutally honest, man. All this shit and hype you see on social media, oh, I just made 250 grand, I just made 50 grand, all well and good. Most of the children that you're watching out there are people that living at home with their parents. Do you understand? Doing Zoom sessions and YouTube from their fucking bedrooms and sharing that they've just passed FTMA challenge and now they're professional traders. If you get clung on that, if you get caught out on that hype and you think that it's going to be possible for you to do that, then you're going to find it's going to be a problem. But for the majority of people in this community, I know this for a fact, you're mature adults, you have responsibilities, families, jobs, you've got bills to pay and everything else. Shit's really got to change. Do you understand? And it really has to change. It just really does. And you need to be planning and preparing for the future and managing everything. And most importantly, anybody who's making a transition for full-time working with bills, family, children, you better be prepared for the worst.